Hi everyone, myself Jay Rawal from Social Central, one of the leading digital media solutions company. And today with us is Mr. Girish Nair, CEO of Club Oxygen. So, sir, first of all, I would like to congratulate you for the winning of two prestigious awards from and prestigious forum ACEF. In this tough times of pandemic, we have done excellence in marketing arena for the industry, which was one of the most badly hit, our hotel industry. And it has been renowned and recognized by the industry. All the efforts what we have took to revive our business, not only for Club Oxygen, but for the hotel industry at large. We would like to have some thoughts from you for this winning of prestigious awards.
First of all, I reciprocate, okay? And I have no hesitation in saying that this award is as much as is yours, okay?
Thank you,
sir. Team, the Social Central team.
Thank you.
As much as it is ours. You guys enacted this strategy brilliantly well.
Thank you.
And, you know, the direction which was given to our marketing team, our strategy, our product strategy, as well as our, marketing strategy, was brilliantly enacted, executed by your team. And this is just a result of that. And I'm really proud. It also gives me a lot of confidence. There's a lot of reassurance which has come with this award. I must admit that it has been a pleasant surprise. Look, we are, in a way, we are a startup company, okay? Though we are part of a big brand, which is the Bobby Chemmenor International Group. And as you all know, that the Bobby Chemmenor International Group is a well-settled, reputed business house down south, which is into the jewelry business. It has about a century, it's a century old group. And to that extent, this is a strong group which has ventured into this this business. But having said that, we are still a new company. We are still a new organization, a new brand. And what has really worked out for us is that, we gathered all our collective experience, what we could, being in this industry, all of us, if you look at the team, we are all been in this industry for 15 to 20 years and even more. So collectively, we have pooled all our experiences into this brand. Okay, we have learned from our limitations. And which is what, when we set out, with Club Oxygen as a brand, Oxygen Resorts as a brand, we are clear in our minds that what is going to be our do's and don'ts, okay? One thing which we said that we won't compromise is, very basic to any business. Though everyone talk about it, many a times, we miss the significance of being a customer-centric organization. So that is something which we have actually injected into our DNA. Let me tell you this. And keeping the customer centricity in mind at all angles. And you would have seen by now that even when it comes to prospecting, okay, the kind of communication that goes into the market, okay, we have ensured, unlike what happens in the industry, we have ensured that we are non-intrusive. Largely, this industry is, this product is an aggressively sold product. You know, let us face it, that's a reality. But we drew a line there. When we started, we said that, boss, look, our marketing strategy, our brand strategy is going to be non-intrusive. Okay? So when it comes to marketing strategy, as you all know, by now, you being a part of the team now, you have been associated with us, you have been part of our success story. And being a new brand, we are here today because you believed in that, in that strategy of ours.
Yes.
You said that this is something which is tough, but it is something which is
Yes.
credible. It is something which is non-intrusive. It is something which is more genuine, wherein we said we will go only digital.
Yes.
Now, for any brand, leave alone our brand, for any brand to even think of going tactically digital is a challenge by
Yes.
itself, right? Being accountable for the top line, being accountable, directly accountable, you as an associate would have felt the heat and the
Yes,
pressure
yes,
of
yes,
it.
yes.
That boss, you are making us directly responsible for sales, for revenue. This is unheard of.
Yes.
Some amount of brand creation, promotion, things are things which usually marketing agencies are good at.
Yes.
But we said that, look, hey, you are going to be directly responsible and you will also be part of the growth.
Entire
Okay,
process.
so as we grow as an
Yes.
organization, as our revenue streams go upwards, you become a partner to us.
So for us also, it was something unique and something new.
It was a challenge,
Yes,
wasn't
it
it?
was a challenge.
Yeah.
And we also took that pride that, hey, this is something different from the odds. Let's give a shot. We did some pilot project. And trust me, the results were so nice that we are happy that entire industry is today
Absolutely.
acknowledging the
See, the
same.
best part here is when there are results that can be measured
Yes.
by way of a campaign, okay? The happiness that you derive out of it
Yes.
as an agency,
Yes.
as a business associate, I don't find pleasure in saying agency. I find it, in a way it's good to say that we are business associates. You know, we are
Yes.
partners basically,
Yes.
okay? That is much more than getting into a brand campaign, leave it to work its own way, and then the results may be there, may not be there, So to that extent, I think we could make a big difference
Yes.
to not only our industry, but I would even go one step further and say that maybe this could be the beginning of how one may
Yes.
want to look at
Yes.
marketing strategy
Yes.
as a whole.
Yes.
And in that, how significant a digital strategy can be where the input is clearly measured by the output,
Yes.
So that is something which I feel is at the core of this campaign, which you guys, along with my marketing team, Rajiv and Arindam and Ashish, could
Yes.
enact into the market. I think, therefore, this award in that sense is deserving,
Yes.
and you guys are the rightful,
Thank you, sir.
owners
But
of this
we
award.
always say that it
Yeah.
is a joint effort from your team and my team as a whole.
I appreciate.
Going forward, I would like to get some inputs from you on our this campaign. So when this campaign was entirely conceptualizing, so as a value, this is something different what we got from you. So a routine client or a normal client would always focus on selling their individual properties. Okay, but we came up with a campaign that unlock your holiday plans. That's it. And we didn't specifically promoted any property of ours.
Absolutely.
We promoted as a group. And eventually it resulted into helping the entire industry, changing the perception of people in such times, whether everyone was skeptical that whether to come out from house or not. And there has been few months where everyone is sitting in house and feeling bored, feeling down. And that time we came up with this campaign. So
And it appealed. It appealed into the
yes,
market. Yeah.
so this helped not only our brand but the entire hotel industry.
Absolutely.
So
Absolutely.
what give you that kind of challenge
See, I'll
that
tell
let's
you,
go
I
ahead
get your
with the
point.
concept, not
Yeah.
the product?
See, yeah. Well said. In fact, I think that itself, kind of complements our business ethics. Okay, so that is where I want to come at. Once, as I told you right at the beginning, you start communicating with the market with a certain degree of ethics, okay, where your communication is sincere, all right, where you keep the customer at the core of your business philosophy, okay, what happens is then you start thinking, for the larger universe, all right. You start looking at things differently and not just at your own business prospects. Okay. So let me give you an instance. Okay. And I also wanted to, welcome you all to our property here, the Oxygen Resorts Royal Chalet at Mahabaleshwar. And if you look around, all right, every aspect of a customer's expectation is very minutely looked at, all right?
Yes,
and that,
we can see that.
Yeah, every aspect of the customer's expectation is looked at. And that happens when you genuinely feel for the customer, all right? So now, if your communication, that lies at the core of our brand strategy.
Yes.
And that is what you have very brilliantly been able
Thank
to
you.
Communicate by way of this Unlock Your
Holidays
plan. All right. So when you communicate that to the customer, you're not selling your product.
Yes.
You're not selling your property. Okay. You can actually flash your camera across the property. And just by doing that, it can sell very well.
Yes.
But we thought that, look, when the customer, the morale is overall
yes.
hit a certain
yes.
low, we got to actually address the customer sentiment and get the customer and build that excitement, that enthusiasm and that hope into the customer.
Yes.
That look, we are ready. We are all here in this property now. We are ready to take care of your family once again. We understand that there is a certain amount of anxiety.
Yes.
Customers are tentative, right?
Yes.
But tell me, you yourself now being here, there is a certain level of security which you
yes,
feel, right?
Yes, yes.
You feel secured.
Yes.
Right? That's what we want to communicate to the customer. So that confidence, that assurance, that belief is what we want to communicate to the customer, not only as far as our product is concerned, but the industry as a whole. See, the industry today is one of the worst hit industry, or rather it's the worst hit industry, okay? And in spite of that, many brands actually went into hibernation, okay?
Yes.
Because aviation, hospitality,
yes.
we all know that, went into complete hibernation.
Yes, yes, yes.
And that's the reality, because if you don't have customers walking into your property, what do you do? Actually, there is no activity, you know.
Yes.
But we worked around our business strategy. We had the support of our customers, our existing customers, who continue to remain connected and engaged with us, right? Through these campaigns, we were able to still create a certain amount of hope in customers, saying that, look, boss, this issue is temporary. We know for a fact that this will tide over with
yes.
time. And you can still look forward to, wonderful times with your family, right? So that message is something which caught the customer's
yes.
imagination. You know, unlock your holidays. So therefore, we actually could do something which was unconventional,
actually.
Which was not, typical to the hospitality industry, right? Which is about waiting for customers to walk in or customers to book holidays. We didn't go into the market telling customers buy our memberships.
Yes.
We told them that, look, we have something for you. This is the right time for you to, consider our membership offer. All right. But we didn't tell them that buy our offer. We have this, we have that. We told them that, look, unlock your holidays. The future holds hope for you.
We tried to correct the perception.
The perception of the customer.
Holding and them
that,
back. Enjoying
that in turn gave us, the continuity of our business.
Yes.
That in turn, helped us to tide over, to survive these challenging times. And I think, we are now moved into the next mode where, as you can see, that we have straight away opened up a new property. We are going to have one more in Goa very soon. Udaipur is the next destination we are looking at. So, this pandemic has actually reinforced our faith, in our brand.
We can sail through tough times as well.
Absolutely, absolutely. In fact, that has been the silver lining for us, for all of us collectively.
Yes.
Isn't it?
Sir, to end this, today, in this hotel industry, a lot of people are struggling. A lot of players are struggling, be it a major player or a small player, a resort owner or a small-time hotelier.
Absolutely.
Okay. What message would you like to give it to them? Everyone is passing from a tough time. What should be their strategy and what should be their focus?
See,
to
I would
get out of this and revive their own business.
Okay, look, we are a 1.5-year-old brand.
Yes.
Okay. And for a 1.5-year-old brand, let me tell you, we have come a very long way. We have close to 10,000 customers now already. Our own and tied up, we have close to 30-35 resorts in about 25 destinations that we offer. We have moved very fast, in an industry which has a productivity of about 2 and 3 memberships per salesperson every month. Thanks to our strategy, our digital strategy, where we said we will be zero intrusive, 100% engagement, zero intrusion. All right?
Sir, you we say could reach yourself that you are just a 1.5-year-old brand. But I'm sure that you yourself come with such a rich experience from this industry. And that's why
absolutely.
Your experience has boiled down to this strategy. And we have been executing this.
So therefore, that in spite of the fact, as I said, that we are a fairly new brand, my point here is the learning, the experience, the success rate at which we have worked gives us tremendous confidence. And therefore, what I can say is, one, change is the essence now.
Yes.
Okay? Convention may not work all times.
Yes.
One has to be unconventional. Okay? One has to see, look, some things could sound very conventional, very basic, but acting upon them is very important.
Yes.
Okay. As we all say, customer is the king. You have to look at creating more and more, you have to surprise the customer. Now you have to delight the customer. Now it is no more about customer satisfaction.
Yes.
It is customer delight now. Okay. So you have to look out for things which could give customer that sense of delight.
Happiness which is unexpected
absolutely.
From them.
See, many a times in this industry what happens is, what I have seen also, is that business leaders, I'm not being critical, okay, I understand compulsions.
Yes.
Business leaders tend to look at the top line.
Yeah.
The bottom line.
Yes.
And then in that, we tend to forget, what is critical and what is core to the business. Yes. And that is the customer's happiness. See, there cannot be. I was telling my team, you know, we were talking about getting some celebrity, getting an ambassador. I was telling them all that our customers are our ambassadors.
Yes.
You know, they, if they go into the market and speak about this, that is good enough. You don't need any other celebrity.
One happy customer will bring in more than
100 customers
for us.
Right?
Yes.
The other thing is, in this industry now, look, there may be some big brands,
yes,
okay? But there are a lot of standalone,
yeah,
good properties,
yes. Yes.
Okay? For them to survive, there has to be synergy.
Yeah.
Okay? Let me give you an instance. Oyo.
Yeah.
Right? From nowhere, where did they get?
Industry giant.
How are they,
yeah,
able to do that? They gave a platform where they could draw synergies and they could kind of,
yes,
build on everyone's, you know, limitations, and they could kind of bring everyone together and create a platform where everyone eventually could benefit. All right? So I think what we are also at this stage, we are also trying to do something similar, a business model, where we are trying to get these standalone properties as part of our business.
Yeah.
And then we are telling them that, look, we have a captive audience.
Yeah.
Our customer base increases every month,
yes,
you know, month on month.
Mm.
What does it mean? It means that the demand for a holiday is increasing as far as we are concerned.
Yes.
Okay. And my customer eventually will go to the property where I, which I offer to him. Okay.
Quality holiday is much more required than a regular holiday.
Absolutely.
Yes.
And when we, if we get these isolated hotels to associate with us, or if these hotels are able to create synergies and pool together, okay, then the opportunity is much more.
Yeah.
It is much more than working in isolation.
Yes.
Because working in isolation now is definitely going to, you know, be a challenge. All right. And then, as I said, one has to think unconventional. One has to think differently. One has to reach out to the customer in a completely different way. Okay, reaching out through to the customer through the conventional ways is always fine, through your OTA platforms, through your you know, the travel agencies and so on and so forth, is definitely going to be there. But you have to also put a lot of, you know, attention towards how you can create a lot of visibility through the digital platform as,
yes,
well. A lot of work can be done in that area as well, you know.
So in today's time, digital platforms and digital media, okay, it plays a very prominent role, because all other media segments are not reaching out to the target audience the way digital is reaching out to them. And also, it leverages us to connect with our target audience in a proper manner, an easy manner.
Absolutely.
Yes.
Absolutely.
And, in a way,
see, what is happening is
to grow with a faster pace.
Correct. See, if you look at it, digital itself, at some stage, gets a little stereotyped,
yeah,
isn't it? So what you guys have been doing is you're doing things a little differently.
Conceptualizing,
yeah, you're trying to do,
yes,
things a little differently.
Yes.
You're trying to create a certain level of accountability as far as you know, the digital campaigns are concerned. So I think that could be the new order.
Yes,
is what I feel.
Yes,
you know, while see. One factor that one must bear in mind is how well a brand campaign, okay, complements the organization's philosophy or the organize. You can't, let me give you an example. You can't talk about great experiences,
yes,
okay, for a customer. Everyone talks about it.
Yes.
What is the big deal about it?
Yes.
Yeah. Which brand doesn't talk about great experiences?
Yes, actually.
Yeah? Any, you go to any hotel, you go to any place, they all talk about good experience,
yeah,
great holidays, and so on and so forth, right?
Yes. Yes.
So isn't that a little stereotype?
It is.
Right?
Ah.
Yeah. So you, one needs to be a little more specific, a little more customized, a little more sincere with your campaign.
So while discussing this, okay,
you know,
we have got this communication from various marketing teams. So we handle lot many clients. But we focus on one thing, okay. We treat communication in a separate manner. We never think that it's a B2B communication or a B2C communication. We always focus to have and generate and create a campaign, which is an H-to-H communication. It's human to human. End of the day, you are a corporate or you are an individual, you are a generic traveler, but you are a human being.
Absolutely.
The messaging which has to go to you from the brand has to be a simple message that, hey, it is going to cater your purpose and
Absolutely.
It is going to solve your purpose.
Absolutely.
And there is always a gap. Okay, we just need to find that gap and fill that gap with a proper communication
Absolutely.
And proper channel.
Absolutely.
And once we do that, sky is the limit for our growth.
Absolutely. 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 I think the thumb rule should be, you should actually, with a purpose, like we have done, you know, in many of our campaigns,
yes.
Unlock Your Holidays itself was done with a specific purpose. It
yes.
was not a vanilla or it was not a stereotype campaign, you know. It was actually customized to the present situation. It was done with a purpose to genuinely appeal to the
yes.
customer sentiments,
yes.
you know. So, such campaigns, you know, it should be done with a purpose that if I am going to talk about holidays, one should actually look at a location and try to bring out the USPs of that location which will appeal to the customer,
sure.
you know. So, since you are asking me about, you know, what could have been at the core of our brand strategy and what could have actually could be a reason why we appealed to ACEF,
yes.
right? Why we appeal to ACEF as a good brand strategy is also because I personally feel that our brand communication has been sincere.
Yeah.
You know, top bottom,
yes.
right from
yes.
The chairman, Dr. Bobby Chemannur, to the team. And right up to you guys,
yes.
there is no ambiguity.
Yes.
The communication is very clear. And that is what the customer looks at.
Yes.
You cannot do vanilla anymore. You know, in this situation, you asked me that what should the industry be doing? The industry should look beyond vanilla, beyond conventional.
Yes.
And maybe that is what you guys have been doing well. And you guys should now
thank you, sir, thank
be
you.
Able
Social
to...
Central will always aim and focus to deliver such kind of services
Absolutely. That
to
is the
all
way
our
forward.
Clients.
That is the way forward.
Yes.
And that is my communication to them, to my team. Now we are also as part of our media strategy, as part of our sales strategy. We are also now making a giant leap of wanting to start selling our product direct to the customer
yes.
through the online space
yes.
without
digital.
Any
yes.
digital, without any human intervention. So far, we have succeeded till the last
mile. Yes.
Okay, so we want to kind of dilute that and now get into direct customer interfacing
yes.
through digital.
Yes.
And
I'm
that,
sure we will integrate it for you
yeah,
and we'll
so
take
that's
it forward.
Absolutely.
Yes.
And in that, we are now wanting to create a website which is going to be a very robust website and that will obviously cater to not only our now what you are doing actually is you are limited
yes.
to our presence, our locations,
yes. Yes.
our sales branches,
yes.
right? Though you may want to go across the country because that is also your playground,
yes.
right?
Sure.
So what we are doing is exactly that. Once we open up the digital space nationally and globally, then the market, the globe is your market, you know. So that's the next thing we plan to do.
Thank you,
right?
sir. Thank you for
mine. Thanks to you guys. Thanks for
valuable
coming.
Thoughts.
Congratulations to each of you, okay?
Thank you, sir.
Brilliant job done.
Congratulations both.
Thank
and
you so much.
Would like to thank ACEF as well for
absolutely.
This
thanks to ACE
recognition, okay? Social Central and Club Oxygen.
Kudos to ACEF.
Yes, kudos to ACEF,
yeah, well,
for admiring our work. Okay, we appreciate
good job
that you evaluated us on this.
Come, Ashish. Arindam, come. Come, man. They are the part of the team. Come. I think, one should truly appreciate the good job being done by them. And I must say this because, see, what usually happens is, I must be very careful and I must be very diplomatic when I say this. But nevertheless, I wouldn't hesitate to say that ACEF is doing a great job.
Yes.
Because it's very easy to get caught in the midst of the real big brands.
Yeah.
And the real big brands, obviously, they do a lot of work and they really put a lot of efforts to get there. But there are some of these emerging brands.
Yes.
Okay. And, these digital marketing agencies who truly do wonders,
yes.
You know. And that ACEF has been very meticulous and very careful to go by merit.
Yes.
And to also award and recognize such brands deserves a round of applause. And I think we all should put our hands together for that. Okay. Thank you.